Hi everyone, thanks so much for joining me. My name is Helen and this is a Shrimpy McGee channel. Do click like and subscribe if you want more of this content. But I know why you're here. You're here to hear about growing out a pixie cut. So without any further ado, let's get right into it. A number of months ago, in fact, actually about 2 years ago, I had a pixie cut. So you can have a look and see what that looks like. I will insert a photo from the past. And I really like this hairstyle. I thought it was super cute. It was pretty easy to maintain in that you just really had to wash it and brush it a bit. What was difficult though is that I had bedhead all the time and there was no cure for bedhead except for washing my hair. So that wasn't too much fun because sometimes my hair wasn't actually that dirty. It's just like nothing I could do, no product I could use, no comb, nothing would push it down. But anyway, I just wanted to come on and, you know, maybe you're having that problem now. Maybe you had your hair cut and you're just thinking of growing out now, or maybe you're thinking about getting a pixie cut, but you're not too sure if you should do it or not because you're not sure how long it's gonna take to grow out. So I'm gonna give you sort of a bit of an idea of what the timeline is like for growing out a pixie cut. Because I notice even in my own videos, and I will link to them here, I've noticed that that's some of the search terms that people are looking for, growing out a pixie cut timeline. So I thought I would give you a bit of an idea. So first you start with your pixie cut, which you probably like, and you're gonna get lots and lots of compliments on it, mostly from women and a few men, but it's mostly gonna be women who are gonna tell you how much they love your hair and it's gonna give you a lot of confidence. But at some point you may, or may not, but you may get tired of having this pixie cut. I know I did. I wanted to grow my hair into a bob. Let me tell you, from pixie cut to bob, it is a struggle. It is kind of, takes a long time, longer probably than you would think. I am a member of a group on Facebook actually about growing out short hair, so I can drop a link for that if any of you are interested in joining this closed group. It is like a support group for other women, and there are a couple guys on there who are just really trying to grow out really short hair, and so everybody cheers each other on and they like give tips about growing it out and stuff like that. It's actually kind of a fun place. So what I did was I just asked people in that group, my fellow hair grower outers, what they thought their timeline was, like what the ugly stage of their timeline was. And without a doubt, I mean, I put my thoughts in there. My thought was about the 6 month point for me was about the ugliest. Why was it the ugliest? Because everything was kind of growing out in different lengths. And then this mullet part was starting to grow out too. So I had to get that trimmed, but then I was dealing with all these different lengths. And so it's just not a really good look. It can be a little top heavy looking. And so everyone there also, not everyone, but a few other people said the 6 to 9 month point after you get the pixie cut. And of course the pixie cut has different lengths, right? But in general, the 6 to 9 month mark afterward, it was the part that they didn't like. A lot of people say that they give up at that point, and I totally buy that. It's really hard when you're in that awkward phase to know what to do. Do you just plow forward or you go back to that cute look because you remember looking really cute, and then you'll invariably see a selfie of yourself back then or like a group photo and you're like, oh my gosh, my hair looks so much cuter when it was short and a pixie cut. I wanna go back to that. And that's how people get suckered in into going back into a pixie cut, which is totally cool if you wanna rock that look. But if you're thinking that you wanna push ahead, keep in mind the 6 to 9 month mark is like the height of ugliness. But once you push past that, you're gonna get a cuter looking hairstyle for most people. For me, I was well into the 1 year mark because I have the slowest growing hair. So my results are not typical. I am about 2.25 years in now to growing out my hair from bald. So basically, for those of you who are not starting from bald, from a buzz cut length, it took about 2.5 years to get to this length that you see here, and you'll see that I even have it pinned up, but my results are not typical. My hair is super slow growing. I actually did measure it, and they say hair on average grows about 1/2 inch a month. My hair does not grow 1/2 inch a month. My hair grows about 1/2 inch every 2 months. So what I've got here after 2 years, I mean, results may vary. This is the slower end of what you can imagine your hair to look like. And don't forget, I have gotten it trimmed. I've not got any of the top trimmed, but I've had tiny little trims just for the back here. Cause like I said, that will grow out much faster. And then you'll have this like weird long hair mullet kind of hairdo, which, you know, someone said to me thought was really sexy, not on me, but just like it could be a really sexy haircut. And I was having trouble envisioning how that could be sexy because to me, a mullet is just not a good look. I don't know, but if you like it, you can rock it. But anyhow, if you don't want a mullet, yeah, you gotta keep up with those trims in the back. I'm a big advocate of getting to know your hairstylist. And so I've made another video about, you know, how to get a really good haircut from your hairstylist. And I will link to that. But in my mind, you know, it's really good to get a hairstylist that you know, because they start to know you when you're trying to grow out a pixie cut. They'll start to understand what your timeline is and where your hair is going and what your goals are. So I think it's great to, before you've even sat down in the chair, know the stylist already and have a bit of a shorthand with each other about what your goals are for growing out your hair. So they know that you're trying to aim for a bob, they'll know that each time you come in, and you will have to go in pretty frequently. That is something to keep in mind. Short hair, even if you want to keep it like in a pixie cut, you're looking at a lot of maintenance. Every woman I've talked to that has a pixie cut rolls her eyes and goes, yes, totally, when I say, don't you find it to be a lot of maintenance in terms of going to the hairstylist? They all say yes. Not a single person among them has said it isn't. So if you want to keep that pixie cut looking nice and fresh, you got to commit to going to the stylist regularly. If not, I got away with about 2 or 3 trims to get to about the length that I have now, which I'm going to show you a bit more fully. You can see I've got it sort of in a half updo, so I'm just going to pull it down and I can show you what you can expect. This took me 2.5 to almost 2.5 years to get to. Your hair will probably grow much faster because mine is super slow growing, but I just want to tell you what you can expect in terms of how a pixie cut grows out. So what you've got to remember is all the hair grows at the same time. It's not like this hair is going to grow fast and grow beautifully into a bob. It's all growing at the same time. That's what makes it look shaggy and kind of not great looking. That's the real challenge of growing out a pixie cut into a bob and then to longer hair, wherever it is you want to go. But your first stage is going to be a bob, unless you go for a sexy mullet, to each their own. But the issue you're going to have here, and you're going to see that I have it, is you're going to have a lot of hair that's different lengths, and you're going to have hair that's kind of lot, very layered, very unintentionally layered. So that's sort of the hair that I'm working with now, because if I wanted it to not be layered and I wanted a blend cut, well, what would we have to do? We'd have to find the shortest pieces, which were about here, and maybe even I can find shorter bits, and everything would need to be lopped to that length if you wanted a more blend cut or if you didn't want all these different layers. So what you're gonna have is a lot of layers, and a lot of layers are hard to style. Take it from me, I've made some videos about it, which I will also link to. I have one about curling your hair when you have really short layers, how you can do that. And the way I do that is with a really small straight iron. It can also be done with a curling iron as well. But anyhow, my hair is looking in kind of shaggy today, and I'll explain to you, this is shaggier than it normally would look. But you get an idea, right? It's kind of piecey. That's what you can kind of expect, from me anyway. Maybe other people have had a different experience, but basically because your stylist is not really able, and my stylist has not touched anything up here, so that's all grown out, and you see it's kind of a little piecey, the hairs are sort of in different lengths, and it gives a sort of layered textured look to the ends. If I wanted it to be blunt and no layers, it would have to come up, right? The height would have to come up, because everything is just a different length. So you're just dealing with the physical reality of all the hairs being a different length. So, I'm not trying to frighten you, and my hair doesn't normally look this sort of PC at the bottom, but what had happened was, it's a really hot and humid day here, so I had my hair all really nicely coiffed. I had all these little nice beachy waves, and they got more and more undone, and sort of at the end of the day now. And so the more undone they got, the more kind of wiry they're looking, so that's why they look the way, my hair looks the way it does right now. I don't want to frighten you, your hair might not necessarily look like this, and my hair is thinner, right? So that's another thing. I don't have like a really lush full head of hair. It looks pretty full. It's very soft though and kind of fluffy. It looks pretty full, but it's not. Like if I made a ponytail, you would see it would just be a teeny tiny circumference, like just, it would be a pretty skinny ponytail. But my hair is not long enough to make in a ponytail. I can kind of pull it back a bit. We're just sort of getting to that point now where I can pull it back off my face, which is like, I gotta say, it's exciting. It is exciting to get there, and it's taken 2 years, but I think that for your average person with average hair growth length, you know, it seems to me that it takes people about a year to get from a pixie cut to a bob, so that's sort of what you can expect if you're starting from a buzz cut and if your hair grows slowly. So I had 2 knocks against me. It's taken 2.25 years to get where I am now, and I'm keeping going. So if you want to hang out with me and see what else I've got coming up, this is the kind of stuff that I specialize in on this channel, all about hair stuff, about thin, fine hair, growing out hair. I've done lots of stuff about Rogaine, so if you're interested in if Rogaine works, definitely check out my videos about that. And you know, I want to hear from you. What kind of stuff do you want to hear about? Just drop me a note in the comments and maybe I will make a video on it. But even if I don't, I really hope that you will consider subscribing and liking this. And yeah, that's about all I wanted to say about the timeline of growing in a pixie cut. I want to know also if you agree, disagree, drop me a note. Thanks so much, and don't forget, you can also follow me on Instagram. I'm at ShrimpyMcGee, which is the same handle is this channel. Thanks everyone. Bye.